Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you. I hope you all are safe and may be excited for my class. So I am here to teach you SST Standard 3, Chapter 20, and the chapter name is New Delhi. So before starting the chapter, I request all of you to please stay at home and enjoy your quality time with your family members. You can enjoy like playing the Ludo, Carrom, video games. In fact, you can complete your homework. So today, I will upload the Standard 3 Chapter 5 question answer in PDF. So please go through the website and check your homework, download it, and please complete down it in your fair copy. So you have a lots of time. So please complete your all homework in good handwriting, illegible handwriting, and use dark pencil. Please follow all the guidelines which government has told us to follow due to this virus. Stay at home, protect yourself and your family from this virus. And I hope that you guys had completed your healthy and delicious breakfast. So eat healthy and stay happy at home. Please give your most of your time in your study, complete your all homework, and please stay at home. And so let's start the chapter. So before starting the chapter, if you don't have the book, then please purchase it as soon as possible. And whenever you are going to eat your meals, please wash your hand properly so that you will be safe from this virus. Now, first of all, before starting the chapter New Delhi, here is one map behind your chapter in your book. So you can see that here, like in the corner side, it's India map, and India in red dot, it's indicating that where is New Delhi. You can see, like, see, I'm going to show you here where. See, it's India map, and you can see here it's a red dot. It shows that in India map, New Delhi is located in this side. So, it is a map of New Delhi. Next, go through the chapter. Now, New Delhi is the national capital of India. So before the chapter, we have learned also that New Delhi is the capital of India. It lies on the bank of river Yamuna. So New Delhi, it lies in the river Yamuna. It is also known as the national capital territory of Delhi. Exactly, it is so it is in Union Territory. So it is also called the New Delhi. It is also called as the National Capital Territory of India. And it shares its border with the state of Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. You can see that in map. So it shares his border. The border New Delhi, it shares its border with the state of Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. Now, we will talk about the climate of New Delhi. How's the climate in New Delhi? So, the climate of New Delhi is one of extremes. It is very hot in summers. So, the climate of Delhi, it is one of the very extremely climate. Like in the hot, in the summer season, it's very hot. A hot dry wind called the Lu blooms in summer afternoons. Like in Bihar also, if in the summer times, afternoon times, the hot dry winds, it is there blowing, that is called Lu. With that off, we can become ill also. So for that, we should not go outside in the summer afternoons. So like exactly as Delhi is also in the summer times in the afternoon, a very hot wind blowing, that is called the Lu. Dust storms are also common. The dust, it can blow. It is also common in New Delhi. Winter are very cold, while July and August are the months when a rain occurs. Now, in the Delhi, the winter are also very cold, but in the July and August are the months where they received the rain. Means the monsoon seasons in Delhi in July and August. Next, we will talk about the topic of history, that what was the history in about the Delhi. We know that in last also chapter we have learned that in New Delhi we have the means like Akbars are there, if they build the Mughal Empire is there, they built different types of famous buildings, palaces. Still now it is there. So we will see about in this chapter about the history of New Delhi. Now, New Delhi become the capital of independent India in 1947. So we know that our India has become independence, then it becomes independent on 15th August 1947. So exactly on the same day, on the same year, the New Delhi become the capital of independent India in 1947. The city of Delhi has played an important role in the history of India. So the city of Delhi, it has played a very important role in the history of India. Many people came to Delhi from outside and settled here. Exactly like from the small country, like some small states like the Bihar and different types of states. So most of the people, they go to Delhi from these places. So they come to Delhi from the outside and they settle their work and they settle their business. They work in Delhi and they just make their life much easier. They brought with them their costumes, languages, art and new ideas. So they come to Delhi because of their own costumes, languages, their art and their new ideas, so that they can go there and they can work and they can stay there. Among them, the Mughals and the British left an everlasting impact on the city. Among these all things, the Mughals and the British, they left a very, means impact, very good impact to the on that city, on New Delhi city. Like the mosques and forts built by Mughals and are also even famous today. So like the mosques and the forts which built by the Mughals, nowadays it is also famous because these all has made in history. Mughal, they made many famous buildings in Delhi were built by British. So many more like buildings are there which built in New Delhi by British. So here your climate topic has completed, that what's the climate in New Delhi, and history also it's completed, that what was the history. Now it's about the tourist attractions. Now how many places are there? I think different many places are there for the tourist attraction, so that tourists can go there and they can like roam there and they can see the different types of buildings and they can enjoy these all things. So about the tourist attraction, we will go through the page 111, it means 111. Now, there are many places in Delhi which are worth visiting. Exactly, because it is the like city area of the Mughals and the British. So they have made a very good cities with different types of mosques, forts, buildings. So it is like a tourist attraction. So many places are there in Delhi which we can go and we can visit there. So first of all, the Rajpath is an important road in central Delhi. Rajpath, where the Republic Day Parade is held. So the Rajpath, it is an important road in Delhi. It is the road where the Republic Day Parade is held in Rajpath Road. As the eastern end of Rajpath is India Gate, while at the western end is Rashtrapati Bhavan. So at the eastern part end of it is Rajpath is India Gate, while on the another side, opposite side of the western is Rashtrapati Bhavan. So what was more tourist attraction is there, that we will see in the next videos. So please guys, watch the next videos. Always attend your online classes. Stay at home, protect yourself and your family from this virus. Thank you. Have a nice day and bye-bye.